Well. Here we are in Sherbet Land. I have a bad feeling about this level, because Sherbet is like ice cream, except that it sucks. So if this level is anything like its namesake, it's going to be like a good level, except for the part where it sucks. Hopefully that won't happen. We are on course number 14. You know, it just occurred to me that there might be like a bit of wordplay going on by calling the levels courses. Since everything is food themed, it might not just be like an homage to Super Mario Bros. 3. It might be like, you know, how you have a 3-course meal. Well, this is so far it's a 14-course meal. Oh, also, these power-ups that I thought were bottles, someone pointed out that they were actually garlic. And that makes sense, because Wario is, like, renowned, like, garlic is part of his persona, I guess. Like, he's known for having bad breath, and garlic would certainly contribute to that. You know, I mean, he's known for just being an overall gross guy. Oh yeah, no more fire. Oh well. What I should have done was I should have used that bird as a platform to give me a little bit of extra momentum. I probably would have been able to make the jump in that case. You know, these look a lot like the pylons. That's probably not the right word. The pylons, the pillars in Yoshi's Island that you can stomp into the ground by doing a butt stomp. But, nope. Alright. Hey, got a heart for that. Not bad. Or got a 1-up, rather. That was close. I came really close to not making that jump. Well, this is awfully early for a checkpoint. I barely have enough coins to activate it, but I guess I might as well go on ahead. This level seems to have, many precarious jumps so far, which means this is probably going to be a level where they won't give me the jetpack hat. The rabbit ears. It's okay. I don't need your power-ups. I'm Wario. I can jump. Not nearly as well as Mario. But you know, I make up for it in other ways, I guess. I mean, I have an awesome mohawk. Mario wouldn't be caught dead with a mohawk. He's too straight-laced, man. He's too square. He hears about conforming to society's perceptions of what an Italian plumber should look like. But Wario, he doesn't have any of that head trip going on. He's his own person. His own man. He doesn't care what society says he should look like. And you know, I admire that about Wario. I mean, sure, he's a jerk who steals people's castles and ships and commits piracy on the high seas. But at least he's out there doing his own thing. Been fortunate enough so far not to run out of lives, so I'm not sure what happens when that happens. It's weird how the bridge only falls in certain spots. Like, it's not falling above this power-up box, which is very odd. I guess the bridge parts don't respawn, so it would be kind of a bummer if you would be able to screw yourself out of being able to proceed. I hit the jump button. I know you guys can't tell on your end, but I definitely hit that button. Maybe I should get one of those overlays, like the speedrunners use, that show what buttons I'm pressing as I play. So, you know, I could prove this. I could prove that I pressed the jump button. Of course, pressing the jump button is only half of the equation. The other half is pressing the button at the correct time. And, you know, I didn't quite nail that part down. Another good part of the equation is not falling to my death. That's another part that I can use some practice in. I've gotten a lot of practice falling to my death. You know. I've got that nailed down. If you need me to fall to my death, I'm your man. So, as I alluded to, oh, you know, I forgot I could hit those with the fire to activate them. As I alluded to in the previous video, I'm probably not going to do all of Sherbet Land in this video, just because I don't really have time to do an hour-long video every day. Half an hour is a lot more doable for me, half an hour to 45 minutes, so, and 45 minutes is actually, that's pressing it a little bit, and, you know, I'd like to keep these videos a watchable length. I've been making them pretty long recently because of my weird obsession with hitting some sort of milestone at the end of every video. Oh man, if I landed on the bird, I totally would have made that jump. So yeah, I'm going to take a break, probably about halfway into Sherbet Land. Assuming I can make it past this level. I haven't had a lot of luck with that so far. If I do lose all my lives, though, and it kicks me back to the beginning of Sherbet Land, at least I won't lose any progress, since I haven't actually beaten any levels in this land yet. I have to say, this is really defying my expectations about how difficult a Mario game is. I mean, I know it's not a Mario game, it's a spin-off, but this is no picnic. I mean, I'm still enjoying it, the level design is pretty cool. And there are interesting elements to the game, but I have to say, repeatedly dying in this level, not a whole lot of fun so far. I don't know, it might get more fun. Maybe if I die 50 times, then I'll start having a blast with it. I shouldn't go after those coins this time. With my luck, the exit is probably right after that point, and it deliberately put those coins there to taunt you. See, the game plays on your greed. It's like, as you play, you know in the back of your mind, you have that coin counter at the end of every level to think of. And the game uses that to make you take unnecessary risks. You have to keep your greed in check. Alright, not going for it this time. Oh hey, secret hearts. You can keep that. So my theory about the way the power-ups hierarchy works is pretty much correct. If you get just the plain garlic, it gives you, the power-up it gives you is different. Whoa, it's icy on this level. I guess that makes sense since it is Sherbet Land. But if you get just the plain garlic and you're small, it makes you big Wario. And if you get the plain garlic when you're big Wario, it gives you the bullhorns, so it's kind of a tier power-up system. Wow, I have a pathetic number of coins. I mean, I'm just gonna have to not worry about that number. I know it's difficult since numbers are pretty important to me, especially in video games. But I'm just gonna have to worry about that number at a later time. Now, it looks like there's a secret exit in this level, so I'm going to try to keep an eye out for that. I can't use my fire on the ladder. I guess that makes sense. I guess I have no reason to kill that guy. I can avoid him easily enough. There's a duck in that ice. No. Trying to melt the ice to get you out, Mr. Duck, but I can't. Ooh. I'll take that. You know, someone in the comments made a very disparaging remark about ducks, and, you know, I didn't enjoy it at all. I'm a fan of ducks. They're one of the better birds, in my opinion. Now, if it was a swan, aw man, then you'd have a point. Because swans are just... they're like the polished turd of the bird kingdom. Like, everyone says, oh, look at how awesome and graceful the swans are. But, you know, when you dig down and see what they're really like, when you see the swan's personality, then you get a different picture of things. Yeah, screw swans. But ducks, ducks are, you know... a duck could be somebody's mother, so you don't wanna talk shit about ducks. By the way, my opinion about swans does not extend to the band Swans, who just came out with a new album pretty recently. That band's pretty good. Not my favorite band, but they're pretty okay, and the new album's pretty good. It's called To Be Kind. It's like kind of experimental, sort of post-rockish, but it's really hard to describe. As far as I know, there's no band called Ducks for me to have an opinion on, although that would be a pretty good name for a Swans cover band. Aw man, I bet if I had fire, I'd be able to melt my way in here. Did I say I like ducks? Let me retract that statement. I like ducks that don't throw scimitars at me. You know, your scimitar looks like a big toenail. Hmm. Oh. Maybe I just had to hit that to get rid of those blocks that was surrounding that exit. Oh wait, no. This is like completely different. Oh wait, no, this is right. Just those ice blocks are no longer there. So I bet the secret exit would be in that room, and I would have to break those blocks to get to the other exit. Well, I guess I can jump back in this level and get there real quick, since this level didn't give me nearly as much trouble as the first one did. Yeah! What's the symbol on that money bag? It was like a dollar sign, but instead of an S, it was a G. It's like gallers. Well, gallers. All right, definitely pressing my luck too much. Not to be confused with the Spelunky Death Roulette currency, Wallers. You think Wallers would be in this game, because it's Wario and all. Oh hey, there's a secret exit in that one too. Alright, Sherbet Land. I'm going to uncover some of your secrets. Some secrets that... Some secrets that I might have missed had I not been paying attention. Oh, I thought maybe Tiny Wario could weasel his way into... Oh wait, he can, but there's probably nothing for me to do in here except get a spear in the face. Because I have no way to actually attack those guys. Unless I throw coins at them, but I don't have any coins. That would be a good place to hide a secret, though. Make it so you have to get some coins and come back to take those guys out. But that didn't look like a place where a secret would traditionally be. So someone left a nice little hint in the comments that you can use this jetpack. You can cancel it in midair by hitting the jump button, and then you can activate it again and have the same amount of fuel as you would have if you activated it on the ground or activated it after the first jump. So you could theoretically keep the jetpack hat going a pretty long time by keep it going a pretty long time by doing that cancel and activate again bit. Yeah, you would lose a little bit of altitude every time, but if you were good, then you could keep it going pretty well. Alright, it's important that I don't lose. I have to at least be Big Mario by the time I get to that room at the end with the exclamation box. Because then I could charge those blocks that's undoubtedly covering up a secret exit. I'm gonna hang on to my coins. I think I'll be okay. I didn't die in this level the first time through, so... A checkpoint isn't absolutely necessary. Alright, this is where I took some damage the first time through, so gotta make sure I make that jump. Just on the ice, you have to have a little bit of a running start to get your momentum up. No, you don't. Hey, come back here. I didn't flamethrower your face yet. Oops. I don't know why I hit that. Okay. So this has to be hiding some sort of secret, right? No. My theory was incorrect. Well, isn't that just a kick in the pants? I don't know where the secret exit in this level is. Man, what if my theory about earlier in the level turns out to be correct? That would be really bizarre. Oh well, I can't, I don't really have time to go back and check, so... Maybe in the live stream, I will attempt to reveal some more secrets in this game. You know, I could use some extra lives. Let's give it a shot. I have 40, so I can do the B course. Let's see if I can actually do better at this than I have been. Oh good, I get to get revenge on those ducks. Nice! Nope. I had the timing right, but the power wasn't there. What the? Bull honky. This is really hard. Oh, I did it again. If you didn't have a time limit, or if you had a longer time limit, it would be easier to work out. Well, I got one extra life out of it, at least. Not really worth giving up 40 coins for, but better than nothing. 2 coins, heck yeah! Alright, so, I guess I should have known better. I should have anticipated that would be a red herring, and they wouldn't put a really obvious secret exit there. And we have one of these Erlenmeyer flasks right off the bat. Hey! Why didn't the flames kill that guy? That was a close one. No! Well, I can't break those open now. Unless, maybe I can throw this guy at him. I don't think that works. Can I throw the key at it? Break it open that way? I don't think so. Pretty sure only a nice, solid hit with the forehead would. Would break those open. I didn't think it would, I thought the arc would have sent that thing's attack flying over my head, but I guess not. Oh, more wall hacks. What? I hit that thing with a key. I just shrugged it off. Gotta be careful not to drop the key down where that spiky ball is. Had a couple close calls with that. Boy, the physics of this game were great before. Let me tell you, adding ice to the equation just takes it to a whole other level. Oh, hey. Well, do I just fall off the right? Looks like that's what I should do. Oh no, the bridge extends. That's nice. Hey, look at all those coins. See, that was a good way to goad me, or coax me, into finding that secret by putting an invisible block there. I mean, you had the one coin that was... Whew, man, that was close. That was kind of out of place. Oh. And that coin makes you suspicious, so you jump at it. But there's no box here. There's nothing for me to unlock. Maybe having a dot on the level icon just shows you that there's a secret treasure in that level somewhere. Maybe that's not necessarily a secret exit. Can't bring this thing with me, right? Doesn't look like it. Well, I only have 12 coins left, so not worth doing one of the mini games. All right, so is that the Is that the secret exit, or is that the normal exit? I'm not sure. I'm assuming this is a secret exit, since I had to, go off the edge of the screen to find it. Aw, man! There's a chest here and me without a key. Is there some way to bring that key with me? I mean, I sure don't see how you could do that. I mean, I went through the door holding the key, and nothing seemed to happen. Huh. That sure looks suspicious. This is probably a bad idea, but I'm going to try. Oh. Wow, I made it. Oh man, I could keep going too. Boy, here's where I needed the jetpack. Maybe that gets rid of the spikes. Oh no, but it does create a platform for me to jump on. Nice. Excellent. Man, I really wish I knew how the secrets of this game worked. I mean, there sure seems to be a lot of them. And I have not yet been able to solve the riddle. I don't want that. Oh well, at least it should make for a pretty entertaining bonus stream. You can watch me beat my head against this game for a few hours. Oh, that was a nice, pleasant little romp. Alright, Queen Game. I don't like you and you don't like me. But if you cooperate with me... I like how if you don't push any buttons, he kind of weighs his options. Do I want to do this one or that one? I don't know. Nice! 38 free dollars. Alright, I think that's good enough. Oh, I almost broke a foul. That's pretty good, right? Oh. Well, I guess that's going to about do it for this video. Tune in tomorrow for the second half of Sherbet Land, in which maybe I might eventually uncover some of these secrets. I don't know. I will try my best. See you then.